we're going to change direction across the diagonal, H to F. Sending one. Come on. Let's go, Waldo. There we go. I'll have to get him to where you feel that he pushes with his hind feet instead of just pulling with his front feet. Okay, let's take him to canter. Put the inside hind leg staying active and pushing. Show me a bigger difference. There we go. Good. And now let him be. And then back to the trot. Okay, so we're going to work on these transitions a little bit. When you're asking him to go to canter, I want you to think about not taking the energy out of his inside hind leg. You're doing a half halt beforehand, which is sucking the energy out of his hind legs and making it harder for him to step into canter. So you want to think about him maintaining the activity of his inside hind legs. Out of the canter, we have to get to where you have him start to drop with his hind legs first, so he caught some more uphill balance. And we'll talk about how to do that as we're going along. Okay. First, let's start on getting him a little bit more active into the canter. Inside hind leg, and you'll know he's pushing harder because he's going to push you out of the saddle a little bit more in the place. Okay, keep your outside rein working. Good, good. Now keep this activity and post into the canter. Better. We're uphill now. So when you go to the trot, I want you to think about keeping your core strong and riding his inside hind leg under, keeping his head, his pole up. Okay, so core strong, inside hind under, and trot. Good difference. Did you feel the difference in that transition to the last one?
Yeah.
So he didn't land in a heap so much that time. So just thinking about having better balance through the down transitions and better impulsion through the upward transitions. Now we're going to do the same idea as we go to the walk, where you're going to keep his uphill balance, have him start with the hind feet, so the front feet, and change the walk. Nice. Really good. Okay, go free walk on the diagonal. Let up, raise. Care more about the stretch. And the length of his stride than the activity. That's better. We're going to go back to medium walk and head. Okay, getting his balance over his front feet like we worked on in the beginning. He needs to be a bit rounder. So, got to tuck his nose in a little bit more. Work your inside fingers against the outside rein. That's better. Good. I'm thinking about creating activity with the inside hind leg as we take him to the bottom. So keep him nice and up. Nicely done. More active again so you feel that he pushes you out of the saddle a bit more. outside. He's lazing around with the Pistons, I think. Like, don't want to draw your inside leg back. You do want to make sure you keep him a little straighter in the face with that. Let's look at that activity again. Active with the inside line. Come on. And now take the camera. I'm going to go large. More weight on your inside foot. Letting your elbows go. Okay, now ride behind feet for the trot. Think about keeping his ears up and having him trot behind feet first. Nice! Another good one. Now have him stretch down in the trot. Atta boy. Straight line in your reins, even though he's willing to stretch, doesn't mean that we're going to let him get a loose rein. He needs to stretch down through the contact and be consistent about it. Do his neck back down. Big overbend.